Dude, what do you think they're saying?
Excuse me, Mish. Tell the man that we come in friendship.
Mish is, dude, my big American friends are going to fuck you up if you don't show us some blown up tanks.
And the Haji's all,
and Mish is all, dude, these Iraqis love the fact that we're here. They fucking love freedom and they thought that those fireballs last night were fucking wicked, dude.
That clip from HBO's Generation Kill was intended to be a funny scene, but it is unfortunately a prime example of the false portrayal of Arabs in film, a portrayal that is solidifying the fabricated stereotypes that we Americans have about Arabs. In this presentation, I would like to talk about some of the main examples of false Arab stereotypes that we see in films today, and some examples of these stereotypes in modern films like Aladdin, Syriana, and The Hurt Locker. There are three main Arab stereotypes that appear in film today that I am going to talk about: the evil Arab, the heartless savage Arab, and the cheating, lying Arab vendor. The evil Arab is the idea that the Arabs are portrayed as the villain in many of today's films. However, the idea of generalizing an entire group of people as a villain is not a new idea. This has happened several times in our history. As we talked about in class, and Ewan and Ewan talked about in their book, Typecasting, there is a time in the early 20th century called the Yellow Peril when we vilified almost all East Asian people in our films. Examples of this are the Fu Manchu books and movies. In addition to the Yellow Peril, the Russians were also vilified in the 1950s with the Red Scare. They were portrayed as the universal bad guy, showing up as the villain in almost every film of the era. In Jack G. Shaheen's book, Real Bad Arabs, he claims that Hollywood portrays the evil Arab as a brute murderer, sleazy rapist, religious fanatic, oil-rich dimwit, and abuser of women. In Disney's Aladdin, the opening song, Arabian Nights, originally had lyrics that were offensive to Arab people. The song told of the barbaric nature of the land and portrayed the evil Arab stereotype. However, Disney changed the lyrics when the movie was released on home video. Here is the clip of the movie with the original lyrics.
Oh, I come from a land, from a faraway place, where the caravan camels roam. Where they cut off your ear if they don't like your face. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home.
Another false stereotype of Arab people in film is that of the heartless savage Arab. This stereotype displays the belief that Arabs are heartless and that they do not care about the well-being of others. The movie Syriana has a good example of this. The following clip takes place right after Matt Damon's son is killed at a party being thrown by the Arab oil tycoon. This scene displays the Arab trying to pay off Matt Damon's character for his terrible loss.
$75 million. Great. That's great. How much for my other kid? You know, if I were your economic advisor, I'd tell you that that's not the stupidest thing, financially speaking, that you've ever done, but probably just the dumbest thing you'll do today.
The final false Arab stereotype I am going to talk about in my presentation is that of the cheating, lying Arab vendor. In films, Arab vendors are portrayed as cheats that only want to steal your money. They don't care if what they are selling you is a quality product or not. The following clip is from the movie The Hurt Locker. It is a scene that portrays an American soldier upset because he was sold a very poor quality movie by an Arab vendor. This is a great example of the false Arab vendor stereotype.
Oh, hey, wait a minute.
Look who it is. Oh, my $5 back, buddy.
$5 for what, man? You crazy? No.
Yeah, the DVD you sold me was crap.
You're crazy, man. That's impossible. That's Hollywood special effects.
No, it was shaky. It was out of focus, buddy.
In all, the vilification of the entire Arab community for our entertainment is wrong. The American film industry is making whoever the U.S. is currently fighting against the bad guy, just like we did when we were fighting the Japanese in World War II and the Russians during the Cold War. Since the War on Terror started, the evil Arab has become the common villain in American films. As Ewan and Ewan talk about in the Writing History with Lightning portion of Typecasting, the bad guys in film tend to be whoever the US is fighting at the time. But what is important to realize is that this vilification is unwarranted. The idea of the evil Arab is an illusion created by Hollywood for the sole purpose of our entertainment. However, we need to stop relying on the people with all the money and power to tell us what to think. We need to recognize that stereotypes are wrong, and that they can be devastating to the people who they describe.